How's the body? It was a first day, wasn't it, today? Or were you back
here? I skated in Phoenix and worked out the whole summer in Phoenix, so I feel pretty good.
Yeah, how do you feel?
I feel actually very good. Better than last summer.
Where do you feel it?
What do you mean? Where?
How do you feel just
quicker? Nothing sore at the back, really feels good, and you know, there's no there wasn't a day that I felt any aches and pains, so I was very happy about that.
When's the last time you felt this good, this early in the season?
I'd say a couple of years ago. Obviously last year last summer after, back surgery, it did feel good and I worked out really hard, but, I could still feel things. This summer, I worked out probably even harder and didn't feel anything, so that was really exciting for me.
In your own mind, do you have to get back to where you're starting goaltender, win lots of games? Like last year, you didn't win too many games, and your save percentage and stuff wasn't anywhere near as good as it should be for you.
Well, obviously, my focus is on having a better year. I always work really hard in the off season, but I think I had little extra motivation this year to be even in better shape and be a little bit quicker and even more fitter. So I think I've done that. So just now it has to transfer into the games.
You've been a really good goaltender in this game for a long time. Is it a matter partially of pride to bouncing back from what was a difficult year for you and saying, look, I can still play?
Well, I think it's a matter of, it's always a matter of pride. Whether a player or a goalie or whoever believes in his ability, and I do. So, for me, if I believe in it, then I have pride for sure. Then, I expect myself to have a better year and, just feel normal and feel useful again.
Was there a time when you lost the confidence that you can be a useful goaltender in this league again? Was there a moment when you said, maybe this is, I'm done? No, was there?
Well, I've never really thought that way. When you go on a long losing streak and nothing seems to go right, it's probably more discouraging than for me it was more discouraging than having lost confidence. I in my mind I believe that I can still play and play at the high level. So I guess I have to, just like I said, I put a lot of work in the summer and trying to put the last season behind and start over.
You went harder than ever?
I did go very hard and I started earlier and I didn't take as many breaks. Hopefully I didn't burn out.
Is there a time, like a regular player like knows he's at the end of the line when he loses half a step or something, he's not as quick as he was. Does a goalie know that his mind, you still obviously think he can play, but would a goalie say, okay, I'm not getting across the crease as fast as I did, or I'm going down, I can't get back up as
reflexes.
Quick. His reflexes aren't just as good as they used to.
I think maybe you can say that about the reflexes sometimes, but then, over the years you get a lot of experience and a lot of stuff with anticipation and stuff. Where you can maybe compensate a little bit, over years you're starting to read the game a little bit better. So, you can say somebody's starting to get slower, but at the same time you get a lot more knowledge of the game. So I don't think that should be an issue. I think more of it, with the older players, they lose either motivation or confidence in themselves, and that's how it's kind of starting to go downhill a little bit.
So when you see Rollins still playing at 42, you're thinking to yourself, oh, I'm only 38.
Well, if you see a guy like that playing, he's 42, yeah, or 42, and he had a pretty good season last year and he had good playoffs. I think it's encouraging for anybody. I think as long as you have motivation and the desire to play, you can play for a while.
What do you think the level of confidence confidence or maybe even faith is in what you can bring to the table this season, Nikolai Khabibulin, in the paying customers, in the Oilers brass of, you know, there's a question mark there, and everyone's waiting to see what you bring this year.
Well, I guess I don't know what to say. I guess the only way for me is to go on the ice and prove that I can still play. I mean, there's no other way I can say what I want, or the people can think what they want. But you know, it'll all come down to when the games start to be played, and you know, if I do well, then you know, everybody will be happy. If not, then I guess not.
Are you thrilled to have your off the ice stuff finally behind you?
Well, it's definitely. Definitely happy about that. That it's over with, and you know, trying to put it behind. It wasn't really easy to go through. It wasn't easy for me or my family. Probably even harder for my family. But you know, luckily it's done now, and you know, I can look ahead.
Are you glad that you didn't want to drag it into this year too, obviously?
Well, I definitely didn't want to deal with it another year, or you know, whatever the time frame would be for that. You know, that's why I did what I did, and you know, so I can come to camp, you know, being over with it, and just you know, just concentrate purely on hockey.
So was it awful?
Well, I'm not gonna lie, it was not much fun, if any. The thing, you know, outside tents was very rough. It was pretty hot there, and you know, just the thing that you have boundaries and you have to do certain things from time to time, and you know, it's not, you know, something that people used to, and that's hard.
How was that? Sheriff's a unique character.
Well, I think he is. You know, I. Whatever he's doing, I guess he believes in it, and you know, I've seen a lot of people there, and you know, it's hard on everybody.
How were you treated, like by the other?
You
didn't have much to do with him, did you?
Well, I think everybody was in a similar thing that I was. You know, everybody would be working in the daytime, so we would just meet up at night, and you know, whatever the times was, for people to come back and. You know, chat for a little bit and then go to sleep and morning start
you
over.
Made sure that you ate before you got back there.
Drink
the food.
Oh yeah. Well, the water we could get, but you know, they had some wetting machines, but the food was. I tried it once and I didn't want to try.
It's not the rest. How hot did it get? What was the worst?
I think it must have been one of the hottest weeks that of the summer there. So. A couple guys had the clocks with the thermometers on them. So I think one day was a Sunday that we were there. It was like a 108 in the shade without AC.
We were concerned you're going to sweat yourself and just be nothing left to you. That's not a good place for a guy.
Well, I think the first 48 hours I was there, I lost like 6 or 7 pounds without just laying in the bed.
Just sitting there.
Just sitting and basically laying. That's all you can do. Like there's nothing else to do.
Did they tell you right away you could go home, or was that after you were already there, like you could go home during the day?
No, I was right away. You know, it says that you know, I had to be there for the first 48 hours, and then there was a work release, and then the weekend I had to be there. So I knew exactly what was going on.
Didn't have to wear pink. That's a good thing.
Well, if I screwed up and say inside the regular tents, then you know, then they can put you up in the pink stuff. So.
Hockey player would never hear the end of that.
Whitney would never let you hear the end of that.